Cutch underway here. Looking at Maverick, she missed weight. That may be due to the fact that she has competed most of her amateur career at flyweight. She stands southpaw to start this contest. Nice left there, lands by Maverick. Diaz, a blue belt in jiu-jitsu. Despite that ground game, she said that she wanted to keep this on the feet, wanted to stay away from Maverick, showing a lot of respect to that strength that she had talked about.
She is, you know, and you can definitely tell by her physique that Maverick is a strong fighter. Getting her, clinching you up against the cage would be a hard thing to deal with.
The UFC is back in Canada on Saturday, December 10th, and the light heavyweight championship is on the line as the king, Daniel Cormier, takes on Anthony Rumble Johnson, one of the more feared knockout artists in UFC history. Can he beat him from their rematch a couple years ago? It is UFC 206 from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, only on pay-per-view.
Yeah, and I mentioned having her up against the cage. Samantha Diaz was able to defend okay, get back off of there, but ate a pretty hard shot on the way out.
Diaz light on her feet, throwing that overhand right.
Maverick looks like she's smiling out there. I think she really enjoys fighting.
You can join in on the conversation on Twitter tonight. Use the hashtag InvictaFC20. It is at TJ DeSantis, at Jules_K_fighter. And of course, at Invicta Fights. Now we see him clinched up. Maverick pushing Diaz into the fence. This is where that strength is really going to come into play.
It is. You know, Maverick has both times clenched up, thrown a hard strike, clenched up over the head, and then worked her way down to the body. This time, she's doing a good job of pinning Diaz up against the cage, grabbing around that head. That happens quite a lot in these fights in the women's division, but sometimes very successfully, other times not. Now, Diaz is wrapped around the head. I would say it is a way of getting your hips a little bit off balance, so. Oh.
Looked like Diaz knew she was going to be, you know, pinned down to the floor here. Immediately pulled guard there. Now she got a half butterfly. Brings it up high here. Maverick needs to make sure she doesn't fall victim to an armbar here.
Look at the way Diaz has turned her body perpendicular to Maverick's so that she can get that arm extended a little bit deeper across her body. Now Maverick's doing a good job of stacking, staying low, trying to free her arm with little jerks.
She was also pinning the knee on the head of Diaz. You cannot knee the face or the head of a grounded opponent, but you can't plant on her head.
You can, and she's doing a great job of kind of blocking out that perpendicular motion. She needs to get that arm free at risk of being swept. If Diaz wants to sweep her, she would tilt her down so Maverick's head goes to the ground and then push her over with her legs. But it looks like Maverick may be getting out of this pretty successfully.
Well, Diaz said she wanted to keep this fight on the feet to stay away from that strength of Maverick. Technique, a lot of times, overcomes strength.
It does, but Maverick seems to be extremely well balanced. I say that as they tip over, but looks like Diaz is now in top position.
Trying to clear the head, she does. Now Maverick trying to establish a guard. Diaz trying to make a count, but look at that. Maverick with a nice little sweep, now in a 50-50 position.
Lindsay Diaz going for that leg, possibly trying to hook that, get that heel hook in there. I can't see the position of Maverick's arms. I think one of them is grabbing the cage. not a legal move, but understandable in moments of panic.
Diaz gives up her back. We'll see if Maverick can capitalize here. About a minute 15 remaining here in this opening frame. Now she has the back. Hard to see if the hook is in and established. It is. Now two hooks in. Diaz tried to break away there. Now she might fall victim to this rear naked choke.
Yeah, Maverick's the grip is there.
That is deep.
Around.
Miranda Maverick trying to pick up her first pro win via rear naked choke. She's trying to peel the hand, though, as Diaz.
Yeah, Diaz is trying to pull that rear hand off. It may be too late. That thing may be sunk in pretty deep. Maverick's trying to get her right hand on the back of Diaz's head to propel it forward and pull her arm tighter at this
Diaz
point.
Trying to punch her way out of it, trying to break the hand position. She might go out here. It is done! Victorious in her professional debut. Nice work from Miranda Maverick. She had to play both an offensive and defensive game. A very emotional Miranda Maverick gets it done at Invicta FC 20.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 4 minutes 26 seconds of the first round for your winner by way of tap out due to rear naked choke, Miranda Maverick.